Welcome to Research Papers Support YouTube channel. Myself, Dr. C.V. Sivaram Prasad. In this video, I am going to explain about how to use a Google Scholar to find out the best journal or best research papers for your interest of field, whatever it may be. Whether you are from engineering science or science and the humanities, whatever it may be. Based on your research, you can find out a lot of papers by using Google Scholar account. So now, in this video, I clearly mentioned the Google Scholar account. So if you want to register for the Google Scholar account, please refer my previous videos in the Research Paper Support YouTube channel. So for this purpose, to find out the good journals or good research papers, first open Google Chrome. In that, type Google Scholar. Google Scholar. So once if you enter the Google Scholar, simply enter the button. So you will get a first link that is a Google Scholar. Please click on this one. Yeah. Whatever you are seeing now, this is the Google Scholar dashboard. Now already I have an account. That's why I registered here. That's why it is showing my picture. So if you don't have account, please register for the Google Scholar account. And you can, if you need any assistance, please watch my previous videos. And I clearly explained how to register for a Google Scholar account in Google Scholar website. So if you observe here, after logging to the Google Scholar, here you will see my profile and my library. My library means the collection of your papers, and my profile is your data. And if you simply click on here, it is again showing my profile, my library, alerts and metrics, advanced search, and also settings are available. Now, if you want know the good journals or top journals in your field, simply click on to the metrics. If you click on to the metrics, these are the top journals from 1 to 100. These top 100 journals are showing by using the Google Scholar. Even these top journals, based on which parameter, means the parameter is H5 index and also H5 median. For suppose, these are overall top publications, but if you need the category, whatever you need, if you click on this category, we have different types are there. That is a business, economics, management, chemical and material science, engineering and computer science, health and medical science, humanities, literature and arts, life sciences and earth sciences, physics and mathematics, and social sciences. Now, I need engineering and computer science top journals. Directly, I will click on engineering and computer science. Here I got from 1 to 20. These are the top 20 journals in the engineering and computer science. But again, if you need subcategory, maybe it is, you are from civil or mechanical, electrical department or electronics department or architectural, whatever it may be, go to here, subcategory. You will find lot of subcategories under the engineering and computer science. From architecture and artificial intelligence, automation and control theory, civil engineering, ceramic, material science, or technology law, textile engineering, metallurgy. Like this, we have up to wood science and technology. Whatever you feel or your choice, you can simply click on this one. Now I will simply choose civil engineering. So after civil engineering, click on that one. The publications, the first one is construction and building materials. The H5 index is 94. And also H5 median is 120. And second one is cement and concrete research. This is a 73 H5 index. Next, automation in construction. Like this, from 1 to 20, these are the top 20 journals which is showing by the Google Scholar. And these journals, most probably all are indexed in whatever the indexing tools, the Scopus indexed, or also Web of Science, SCI, SCIE, ESCI. So if you know whatever the journal you are choosing, so please check whether it is indexed in which indexing tool, like Scopus or Web of Science. So for that purpose, I made already some videos. Please go through my YouTube channel. You can find out how to choose whether it, how to select or how to know whether the journal is indexing or not. And next, so move on to another one. So once if you go know the dashboard of Google Scholar, here, for suppose I want an article. For suppose maybe my area of research is nanotechnology, so simply type nanotechnology. Again, it will show you or it will suggest you some nanotechnology related papers, and also it is suggesting nanotechnology applications, nanotechnology in agriculture, nanotechnology in food, nanotechnology in medicine, nanotechnology in concrete, like that. But now I simply enter the nanotechnology, I click on enter button. So later it is showing lot of papers. What are the available papers? Maybe it is in Science Direct or Academia or ResearchGate, whatever it may be. And it is showing lot of papers here. You can find out more papers here. And also the search engine also in Google Scholar is very important. Why? Because if you want very latest papers, or suppose we are in 2020. So if you need only 2020 papers, simply here go to left side. Here it is there since 2020. Or if you need from last year also, from or since 2019, simply click on this one. And again since 2016 also is there. And also there is one more beautiful option is there, custom range. So in that, from which year you want to know the article, simply give your years. And also sort by date, you can click on the date also. Based on that, you can sort your research paper. Later, if you choose both, include patents and also include citations, whatever it may be, if you need with along with the papers, if you want to include patents and also citations, simply click on this one. Now, if you observe here, the nanotechnology, once I click, it is showing a lot of papers. Now I open a new tab in each paper here. Okay, the second one is introduction to nanotechnology. So I will open this first paper. This is the polymer nanotechnology and also composites, which is published in Polymer volume 19, issue 15, July 7, 2018. The pages are 31872 3204. So this is the paper, Dr. Paul, and also if you click on this one, this is the affiliation. So you can find out like this. Next, one second. Yeah, here also, if you see one more paper, impact of nanotechnology on drug delivery. So you can see how many article views are available, article metrics and citations, 1847. Maybe the book also you can see here, and also safe handling of nanotechnology and all. So like this, you can see lot of papers regarding this one, okay, regarding nanotechnology. And one more beautiful thing here, once if you cited or if you read out this paper, whenever you are preparing a manuscript, you can cite this paper. For that purpose, please click on this one. It will show you, maybe it will rotate. Then after that, it will give some options, the citation options. Those are different types of the citations options are there, the MLA type, APA, Chicago, Harvard and Vancouver. Now, most of the cases we use MLA and also Harvard. So it depends upon the your journal requirement. This is the most important case. Same like that, whatever the journal, it is showing cited by 3409. And also these are the authors of that paper also. Now, once if you know the topic, it is very easy. Sometimes if you know a professor, but you must know about how many publications he published, like that if you know, so directly you can simply enter his name. I will show you that one. So before that, not only nanotechnology, now I enter artificial intelligence here. It is showing all artificial intelligence related papers. The first one is artificial intelligence, a modern approach and principles of artificial intelligence and artificial intelligence approach. So like that you can get lot of papers, and already I told you here how you will sort out these articles and all. So now I need a researcher, that is a C. Venkata Sivarama Prasad. Now I entered here in the Google Scholar dashboard. I simply click on here. And it is showing C. Venkata Sivaram Prasad, Associate Professor, and it is a verified email at a website of his institution, and the cited by total 21 citations for his journals. Now you can check all his papers like experimental investigation, bacterial concrete, strength with baseless subtilis, and crushed stone dust aggregate based on ultrasonic pulse velocity. So like this, you can check all his papers, whatever he wrote. So directly you can cite his papers also. Now for suppose I use this paper, simply I click on this one. Here I will choose any citations process or type, directly I will take and paste in my manuscript. Okay, now I will click on this author, C. Venkatasivaram Prasad. So directly it will redirect it to the Google Scholar of his account. Now you will see here the Google Scholar account, his name is showing here, and also his designation and his institution, and also these are the field of interest of this researcher. These are the tall structures, bacterial pond, earthquake engineering. And if you get some alerts from this author, whenever he uploaded a paper, a research paper, or conference paper, or a book chapter, or patent, whatever it may be, if you follow this researcher, definitely you will get alerts in your Google Scholar. And next, if you observe here, these are all the journals uploaded by this author. And these are the citations, how many citations for the each journal. And also here, in which year he uploaded his paper, in 2014, 16, 20, 18, like that it is showing a lot of papers. And if you observe here, cited by citations, total citations having 21 since 2015. And also H-index papers are 3. These are the H-index citations, and I-10 index are 00. And if you see this graph, most of the time in the 2020, he got highest citation. Those are the 12 citations. The remaining maybe it is a 2, 3, 2, and 3, and 1 citation. So totally had 21 citation. And in that, you can see, you can add co-authors also. And it is showing here co-authors of the researcher. So like this, we will find out a lot of journals and also a lot of researchers by using a Google Scholar account. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please like, comment, and also subscribe my channel. Thank you so much.